it's nice to always, I think, see what people are doing in different parts of the world. And I always say that the gift of this pandemic, I mean, amidst all the loss and the deaths and everything, has been the fact that we all realize that we're within reach of each other, and that we have these tools that we can connect with.
Welcome, welcome, everybody. So hello, I'm Floy.
This is your Oracle Ngoy.
I'm from Paris.
Yeah, I'm currently in Amsterdam, but I'm from Johannesburg.
De mon vrai nom, Yoan Ngoy Yolande.
I'm in South Africa at the moment. I'm from Zambia.
I'm a sound artist.
I'm a sound artist and musician too.
Je suis artiste, musicienne, rappeuse, slameuse et performeur de la République démocratique du Congo.
Mostly, I work with hardware and samples and field recordings. And voice, but in a very way, in a very where I try to merge art and technology.
Yeah, I'm doing a residency here at the Rex Academy. So we just finished up our like yearly open studios exhibition thing. So I also feeling a bit lost because kind of do this work and then it's seen by the public and then you're kind of like, now what?
So I'm doing a residency right now also at Amplify Berlin, which has been great in giving me an opportunity to kind of set my voice and my foot in Germany as an artist, even though I grew up in Germany and I'm currently living in Berlin. I live for many years now. I went back to Cameroon, where I am from, where I live. That's where I kind of started this artistic practice that is now finding people.
Et donc, depuis un certain temps, je m'étais dit, il faut que j'essaie un peu de mettre des artistes femmes en synergie. Et c'est ce que je fais. J'ai créé le collectif Africa Diva, un collectif qui œuvre dans l'émergence des talents féminines en RD Congo.
Generally, I work quite a lot with ideas of migration. And the text itself has been called Jacaranda Time in its two iterations so far. Stories and legends and information I have about my family, I suppose, my lineage is the initial inspiration. And then I have fictionalized and futurized these stories into a performance text. So the jacarandas, I don't know if jacarandas are, they're a phenomenon in certain parts of the continent, and they are migrants, quote unquote, migrant alien, beautiful trees that have a strange colonial history. So the jacaranda of the title is also woven into this idea of migration. And then the jacaranda tree has these beautiful purple flowers. It's reopening here. I did my first concert on Friday since a few months, two concerts actually.
I'm doing a commission for like 10 young artists. And that's really been giving me a lot of energy because like since last year, we've been closed the space and it's been difficult. I mean, to not have live stuff. I mean, I'm a live performer. My background's in dance, my background's in theater. So, I mean, you can film stuff and you can stream stuff, but it's really not the same. So the project is called New Folklore, and it kind of was a provocation to just young people to speak to older people and find out stories that aren't told as much anymore, and then to put their own spin on them.
I'm working on a long-term project about genealogy, which is based around a sculpture that I'm going to show you, and it's an interactive sculpture, sound sculpture, for the moment named Sonic Totem.
So I've been interested in honeybees and the way they communicate knowledge within the hive.
So this is the sculpture. So the round thing in wood is the interactive piece. Okay, this is the interactive Quran with the 8 sensors triggering the 8 banks and everything. That's what's inside the Quran. So it's just Arduino. It's not very, and 8 distant sensors. So it's half about hybrid between very ancient, very contemporary, modern, futuristic bit, like the time machine. It provokes.
I love this phrase, the provocative time machine.
This is this is them. There's 10 of them. It's just this really cool mix of artists and stuff. And we have our first presentation of the work that they've been making this Friday.
So I've been following a beekeeper for a few months now and trying to capture this dance. They dance in a shape that looks like the number 8, almost like infinity sign. Depending on the direction of the sun, maybe 45 degrees from where they're doing the dance, or like 105 degrees, is exactly where the source of the food is. So it's a very intricate dance to not only communicate within the hive, but also it's quite a numbers game in terms of where the source of food is.
She was, he is, they will be an approaching thunderstorm. She is a September breeze at his back. He was a suitcase. She dreamed a path lined with purple blossoms. He will be the distance between here and Maputo. She is walking. He was walking towards her all of his life. She is a story. He was a pile of shoes with the soles worn thin. He will be a song. She will find a purple omen on her shoulder. He was a song, an old song that the old people used to sing. They are a field of maize, mile after mile between Harare and Lusaka. She is a dusty sunset. He was a passport photo. She will be the road that rises up to eat the shoes off his feet. They are blue lilac purple atlas. She is a hole in the road. He is a small stone and a herd of goats. They were the first rains approaching. She will be here tomorrow. He is hope.
En tout cas, c'est toute discipline confondue, mais quand on est une femme artiste, la porte est ouverte pour les collectifs Africa Diva. Et on a pas mal nagé dans différents projets. Mais après, je m'étais dit, ça serait bien d'avoir un grand projet qui nous identifie un peu comme notre bébé. Et c'est là qu'on a créé Yambi City, le festival. Yambi, en Lingala, ça veut dire accueil chaleureux, soyez le bienvenu chez nous. Quand on dit soyez le bienvenu, on dit Yambi, chez nous, un peu comme ça. Donc du coup, pendant plus ou moins une semaine, on transforme Kinshasa en une zone qui accueille des artistes de l'extérieur et d'ici qui travaillent dans des workshops ou dans des échanges carrément. Et on essaie aussi de ramener des professionnels qui peuvent venir et essayer un peu de renforcer en capacité les artistes femmes, parce que ça, c'est aussi un besoin qui fait partie de notre quotidien en tant qu'artiste ici en RD Congo.
I'm interested in different ways in which knowledge is transmitted, especially outside of a human discourse or human understanding. So how do we think of knowledge amongst the ecology at large?
Okay, so this is Terra Alta. The name means higher ground, and we literally had to raise the ground about 5 feet. So this is the rehearsal rooms, and this is like the front garden. And that side behind me is the library. And like a little gallery classroom space. And there's two residency rooms upstairs on the other side. And this middle space is going to be the actual theater.
La musique en RD Congo est pour nous plus que de l'art, c'est vraiment une identité. Et je m'étais dit avec mes mots, je vais essayer de présenter mon pays à travers sa musique. Donc, je suis en train d'écrire déjà quelques phrases. J'espère que ça va beaucoup plus évoluer parce qu'il y a beaucoup d'idées qui me viennent en tête. Beaucoup de choses que j'ai envie de dire, mais je ne sais pas si je serai aussi limitée. Mais voilà, je vais vraiment, à travers ces projets que je parle un peu de mon pays. Et j'ai même donné un nom, mais bon, j'espère qu'avec le temps, peut-être ça va partir. J'ai écrit quelques phrases, je vais partager ça dans le groupe d'un moment à l'autre. Voilà, en gros, sur ce qui est de moi, en fait, pour l'instant.
J'ai dit que je suis connectée avec tout le monde dans ce groupe, dans les différents liens, les différents chemins, les différents lieux. Et je suis très, très contente que vous êtes tous dans le même espace, ensemble.
I think it's also good to kind of connect with everyone's reference points. And what do we do with those reference points that were kind of in the context of this project of sending and receiving these different kind of mailed gestures? Like, what do we do with the way in which we think about how we reference? Because like the way we were trying to go around in circles in terms of the time zone, like whose time zone are we talking about?
Greenwich Meridian Time, the famous one, this one we started with, is passing by Accra.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it could be Accra Meridian Time also, you know.
It really could. or Tema Meridian would be, I think, more accurate. So it's the, we're closest country to the center of the world, because on the other side of the world, it's just water. So that's something they've been trying to like claim.
Okay. Yeah.
So that goes through Tema Meridian time. TMT, guys.
Yes. I'm here
TMT.
For it.
Yes. I'm writing that down.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Reformatting the idea of a time zone around us, maybe towards more of an African sensibility in some way.
Yeah.
Or even just what is developed out of this group.
Like, it's a big thing, Pünktlichkeit, time in Germany. Speaking of new time zone, and I'm always late, basically. Yeah. And that's something like I say that, like I'm always late, but always on time somehow. Like I say, always late in German, of course. But, and that's something that I kind of quite realized also, like the fact that I went to Cameroon and worked there and came back and feeling just like, I'm in Berlin, electronic music, electronic gear, and I don't know nothing about it. Always feeling like I'm a bit like left behind. And it just feels like I'm on time for me, not with the whole thing. Like if COVID has gifted me one thing, it's to find back my own time.